quickly. So the meaning of A3 not equals to 0 is I am feeding the power at port 3. Okay. I want to now prove that whatever the H plane T junction, the S matrix which I have derived, making use of that, making use of the concept of S matrix representation, I can prove that this T junction can act as a power splitter. Okay, jo port 3 se jab input jayega, it will exactly, you know, it gets divided between port 1 and 2. So I want to prove that mathematically. For that, I am taking this case where A3 is not equal to 0 means I am feeding the power through port 3, and A1 and A2 equals to 0 means no power coming from port 1 and port 2. Okay, considering this condition, if I substitute this in these three equations which I have got, these are the three equations which I have got, B equals to S into A. If I multiply row and column, B1, B2, B3, I will get three equations. Substituting this case, these values in these three equations. So what will be equation B1 is equal to? B1 is equal to, this will be removed, this will be removed. Okay, A1 and A2 dono 0 hain. Only it is A3 by root 2. And what is B2 is equal to? Again, these two terms will go. A1 and A2 are 0. It is again equals to A3 by root 2. And what is B3 is equal to? B3 is again, both will go. B3 is 0. See why B3 is 0? We have assumed that, if just recall, listing the characteristics, we have assumed that port 3 is a perfectly matched to the junction. So completely the power gets absorbed. Nothing will come out from the junction to the port. Reverse kuch nahi aayega. There will be no reflections. So B3 is equal to 0. So ye to yahan par prove ho gaya. Port 3 perfectly matched to the junction hai. Okay. So coming to B1 and B2 equations. So I will be getting these two. B1 is equal to this, B2 is equal to this, and B3 is 0. So what do you mean by this B1 and B2 is equal to this? You can see where the magnitudes are same for both B1 and B2, and it is equal to A3 times root 2. Okay. And the sign is also same, positive only. So the meaning of this is, whatever I feed the input power from port 3, it gets divided equally between port 1 and 2. Because my values, if you see, both are same. A3 by root 2, A3 by root 2. And even sign is also same, positive. Without any phase difference, you know, phase change nahi rahega. Jo bhi field jayega andar, when the, you know, it gets divided between port 1 and 2, field ka direction bhi change nahi hoga. It will be same. Just let me show you the diagram. See here, when I feed the power here, see the direction of the field. Both are in the same direction. There is no phase difference, okay, between the field components in port 1 and port 2. So this is one thing. And port 3 is a perfectly matched junction because B3 equals to 0. This is one thing we got. Now, to get the power splitter term, what I will do, let me consider three power values, P1, P2, P3. Where these indicate, the P1 indicates the power coming out of port 1, P2 is the power coming out of port 2, and P3 is the power coming out of port 3. So instead of taking these A's and B's, which are your incident wave and reflected waves, let me take the analysis in terms of power terms, right? Because power and a field, whatever we talk, power and energy are important for us whenever a wave propagates. So expressing the analysis in terms of power, what we have concluded here, whatever the input we feed in port 3, it gets divided between port 1 and 2 equally. Magnitude bhi same hai and direction bhi change nahi hoga. So how I can justify that? By using powers, power at port 3 is equal to jo bhi power port 3 mein feed ho raha hai, that gets equally divided between two ports. Means, agar aap dono ports ke powers ko combine karoge, which is nothing but your port 3 power. So, I can represent this, whatever conclusion we have got in terms of power in this way. The junction is lossless, no losses. P3 is equal to P1 plus P2. Okay, jo dono ports mein equally divide hoga because of the plane of symmetry. Okay, symmetric junction hai wo. And we have seen the values are same here. 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2 times, even no sign change also. So that how I can take it, either take P1 is equal to P2. So if you take both powers equal, either it will be 2 times P1 or 2 times P2. Okay, if you take the ratios of powers, okay, if you take the ratios 10 log to the base 10, because generally the powers and you know the attenuation terms, they are expressed in terms of dB, semi log scale. So if you take the powers of P1 and P3, 10 log of P1 by P3. But what is P3 is equal to? Just now we have got either it is 2 times P1 or 2 times P2. Here also you can take either P1 or P2. Kyunki dono ports ka power to same hi hai. Equal division hai. So you can take any one, either P1 or P2. If you take P1, express P3 denominator also in terms of P1. Agar aapko P2 lena hai, to take P2 divided by 2 times P2. That's it. So if you take this, P1 gets cancelled. Just I have substituted for P3 here. You'll be left with 10 log of 1 by 2. So 10 log of 0.5. You can calculate from your calculators. 10 log to the base 10, 0.5. What is the value? You will get approximately minus 3 decibels. So the final conclusion is the H-plane T junction act as 3 dB splitter. The power gets split among port 1 and 2 equally. That is, the 3 dB down power comes out of port 1 and 2 equally when the power is fed into the H arm, that is port 3. So this is the final conclusion. So what I have done here in the H-plane T-junction, initially I have introduced how the T-junction is formed. Then listing the characteristics, I have written the S matrix. 4 unknowns we got. These 4 unknowns, by making use of the properties, we have found the 4 unknowns, and using B equals to S into A, I have finally arrived at this conclusion that H-plane T junction can act as a 3 dB power splitter. So, jo bhi power port 3 mein feed hoga, it gets equally divided between port 1 and 2. Okay, coming to the E-plane digit T junction, let me just quickly give you the brief so that remaining can be given as an assignment to you. You can see the structure. There is a difference. Ye to same hai, collinear arm. It is same. Earlier also you have seen it was same only. But the difference what you find is earlier yahan par slot tha. Okay, English alphabet T. Yahan par slot karke the side arm was attached. But here this time it is above. Okay. I cannot show you two-dimensional figure, okay? You have to imagine it. Ye upar rahega. That I can show you here. This was your H arm, okay? Side se aapko yahan par side arm tha, okay? But if you see, ye above hai, upar hai. So this is your E-plane T junction. See, ye already humne padha hai. Ye collinear arm dono ke liye same hai. Ye aapka cut yahan par hai. This is above. That's the difference. Yahan pe side se nahi hai, upar se hai. So that is your E-plane T junction. So let me just introduce about E-plane junction to you very quickly. E-plane T junction is formed when a rectangular slot is cut along the breadth of a long waveguide. Earlier it was width, now it is breadth. This one. Earlier humne yahan par slot kiya tha, along the width. But now it is along the breadth, okay, not along the length. ये आपका विड्थ है, ये आपका ब्रेड्थ है. Cut along the breadth of a long waveguide and the side arm is inserted from the top. ये top से आपको ये side arm attach होगा. And we call this side arm as E arm. Earlier it was called H arm. Why it is so? Earlier जो भी field है, field you can see the directions. ओके यू कैन सी हियर, ये जो भी साइड आर्म है दिस इज पैरेलल टू द एच एच फील्ड बिकॉज ऑफ विच वी कॉल इट एच आर्म. लुक एट द ई प्लेन टी जंक्शन, ये आपका इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड है वर्टिकल लाइन से, एंड यू कैन सी आर्म इज ऑल्सो वर्टिकली केप्ट. सो दिस इज पैरेलल टू ई फील्ड, ये जो साइड आर्म अटैच्ड है दिस साइड आर्म इज पैरेलल टू द ई फील्ड बिकॉज ऑफ विच वी कॉल इट द साइड आर्म एज ई आर्म. ओके कमिंग टू द स्ट्रक्चर यू कैन सी एनी डिफरेंस यू फाइंड. नो डाउट जो जो साइड आर्म अटैच्ड है दैट साइड आर्म स्ट्रक्चर इज डिफरेंट. Any other observation? Please have a look. Try to identify the difference. There is also a plane of symmetry here, right? Structure equally do half mein bat gaya hai. You know, this is a divided structure. If you fold it, symmetric, perfect symmetric hai. Ek ke upar ek aa jayega. That is your perfect plane of symmetry. We call it. You have a collinear arm. You have two ports. You have a port three. That is side arm or E arm. Any other observation you can make here? Width. Okay, fine. Structure wise, okay. Because I have only explained you the difference between the two structures. Earlier we had attached the arm here. Okay. Now it is above. That one thing. Any other observation? Yeah. Please observe it and let me know. The main difference between the E plane T junction and H plane T junction, apart from the structure wise to alag hai hi, yahan par side arm hoga, yahan pe upar side arm hai connection. The physical structure is okay, there is a difference. Check the direction of electric field lines. Yahan par above vertical hai, upar ki taraf ja raha hai. Observe at the port 2, they are coming down. So here the same structure I have drawn for the fields. If here they are coming, they are going up. Here they are coming down. So there is a phase change here. Whatever we have done for H plane T junction, listing the characteristics, S matrix, finding the S matrix, then B equals to S into A. Everything we will follow the same. जैसे हमने H plane T junction के लिए किया है. Similarly, we will be going for here. Whatever conclusion we have drawn here in the earlier, the conclusion was both values were equal, A3 by root 2, A3 by root 2. But when we come to E plane T junction, yahan par phase change honne wala hai. There comes a negative sign. Okay, that's what I wanted to show you. That's why I asked you, what is the difference in the structure? You can find the field lines, jo bhi yahan par hai and idhar hai. These field lines, they are in opposite direction. So there is a phase change, 180 degrees phase shift hoga. Okay, so coming to the structure, when the microwave signal is allowed to propagate through the E arm, this one, E arm, okay? These E lines, they turn at the corner. You can see here, yahan par hai na, the direction change is at this corner. Okay? At the corner, reorientation happens there at that meeting point in such a way that there is a phase shift of 180 degrees is produced between the E lines of port 1 and port 2. You can see yahan par upwards hai. यहाँ पर ना ओरिएंटेशन चेंज हो जाएगा इन दिस रीजन. एंड हाउ द ओरिएंटेशन विल बी, इट इज इन सच अ वे दैट व्हाटएवर द फील्ड लाइंस दे आर देयर बिटवीन पोर्ट 1 एंड पोर्ट 2, दे आर हैविंग अ फेज शिफ्ट ऑफ 180 डिग्रीज बिटवीन देम. कमिंग टू द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, आई विल नॉट बी गिविंग यू ऑल द डिटेल्स. It will be given as an assignment. That's what I said here. Because of the plane of symmetry, same. First characteristic, again, we are considering the same. We have already discussed H-plane T-junction. So for even E-plane T-junction also, because of the plane of symmetry, jo bhi aap power फीड करोगे पोर्ट थ्री में. ओके आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू अ स्कीमेटिक हियर. पोर्ट सॉरी पोर्ट टू, दिस इज नॉट पोर्ट थ्री, दिस इज पोर्ट टू. सो वट एवर पावर यू फीड हियर, इट गेट्स इक्वली डिवाइडेड बिटवीन पोर्ट वन एंड टू. बट वॉट इज द चेंज हियर, देर इज अ 180 डिग्रीज फेज शिफ्ट. That's why what I have taken here, whatever the microwave power is fed into port 3, it divides equally between port 1 and 2, but there is a phase shift of 180 degrees between them. In the sense, suppose I'm feeding a power here, it gets equally divided. The port names are changed here. They are not which I have used. So let me go back to my structure. Else you will be again in confusion. Here also I have taken this as port 3. But in this figure, the port names are different. You can use any names. But as I have already prepared, better not to change my values. Let me quickly show you. It's here. See, the port names what I have used, they are port 3 is your sidearm. Okay, but in the figures which the images I have shown you, they are port 1 and 2 different. So if I take the power feeding from port 3, it gets equally divided between these two ports. So what is the S value here? It is S, input is 3, output is 1. S31, right? S31 is equal to, you have S31 is equal to S32, but there is a phase change. So you have to take is equal to minus. Any one value you take minus. One is the negative of the other. So earlier this negative sign was not there in H-plane T-junction. But here we will be getting, for the first characteristic, there will be a negative sign. So remember that is one more difference you can find between E-plane T-junction and H-plane T-junction. So you can take any one negative sign either here or here. Now, second characteristics. Again, port 3 we consider as a perfectly matched junction. If you take that, there will be no reflections. You know, jab port 3 se power feed hoga, nothing will hit to the junction and comes back to port 3. Completely absorbed hoga. So S33 will be equals to 0. Second characteristics. Third characteristic, there is a symmetry. We have already studied S matrix properties. We will be using symmetry property, third property. So how I can write the S matrix for this particular E-plane T junction? Let's see the difference. First value is S11, S12, S13, S21, S22, S23. This is original matrix I'm writing. S31, S32, S33. And I have not listed here that this S matrix for E-plane T-junction is a 3 cross 3 matrix. It is understood because already we have discussed H-plane T-junction. So it is understood that here also we have 3 ports. So it is a 3 by 3 matrix. So totally 9 elements will come here. So first 3 elements I have written as it is. Coming to the second, S21 is equal to S12, symmetric property. S22 I have written as it is. S23 is equal to S32, right? A symmetric property. And from the first characteristic, what is S32? It is minus S31. And again, take one more symmetric property, minus S13. 31 is equal to 13. So again, there is a negative sign here. Earlier, this negative sign was not there. Coming to S31, take the symmetric property S13. S32 is equal to minus S31, which is minus S13. Minus S13. And S33, second characteristics, perfectly matched to the junction, it is equal to 0. So this is what, how many unknowns we have got. Again, the same number, we will be getting 4 unknowns. So totally yahan par jo 9 unknowns the, we have reduced it by using the characteristics. We have got 4 unknowns. 4 unknowns. What is the difference you find in both the matrices? You have a negative sign here. earlier that negative sign was not there in case of H plane T junction. Now coming to the solution, I need to find these four unknown values. For that, let me take the unitary property S into S star. S star is the complex conjugate of S matrix, is equal to unit matrix. So take this original matrix, I have written here, take its conjugate is equal to identity matrix. So till this I have explained you. Remaining things, the solution that I am giving you as an assignment, multiply rows and columns, whatever procedure we have followed for H plane T junction, try to follow the same procedure. You know, take these three diagonal elements for your reference, you will get three equations. First row, first column, second row, second column, third row, third column. Aapko teen equations milenge. Then the fourth equation, it is up to you which one you want to choose. It would be better if you take the third row element. Kyunki yahan par zero aayega. So you can take third row either with the first column or second column. It's up to you. I think even you can take, go for third column. Third row, third column already we have taken here. Okay. So only two options are left for us. First column and second column. So it's up to you. Fourth equation aap kaun sa loge. Try to solve, try to find the S matrix, complete S parameter, the inside entries of S matrix. Okay. So hope you will complete this. After that, I will just show you how in terms of powers and what is the analysis, what conclusion we can draw from the final B equals to S into A in terms of powers. Okay. How it acts as a power splitter. Hope you will be completing this work.